Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, we are going to be creating this employee directory dashboard. I will show you what it looks like and then we'll go over step-by-step how to recreate it. So here is the database that is getting pulled into the dashboard. So the dashboard, of course, needs information to be fed into it. And this is the database. I have created this exact database in a previous video. So what I'm going to do is drop the links to that video so you can go ahead and check it out. It's very basic table, nothing special here. And then this information feeds into this dashboard. This is what we're going to be focusing on creating today. So you can see an overview of all the employees here and then some specific information for individual employees. All right, so let's go over our checklist. So as usual, I have created a checklist for all the steps we're going to cover to get me more organized. In addition to that, this video will be broken down into chapters because videos like this tend to be really long because I'm showing you step by step how to create something. So hopefully the chapters will make it easier for you to navigate through the tutorial. That being said, let's cross this off as we have completed the template overview. Next, I'm going to show you the setup tab and the employee database. All right, so here is the setup tab and it creates all the options that we need to create dropdowns for the employee database. All you need to do is create the tables, add in your options, and then connect that to your database. And this is the database tab. As you can see, it has several different columns and you can add more or delete some to fit your specific need. This is the table I will not be recreating because we do have a video that goes through exactly all the steps you need to create it. It's a very simple table and you can try doing it on your own or follow that tutorial and then come back here so we can create the dashboard. I'm just going to scroll through so you can see exactly what I have just in case you're planning on using this exact same style for your template. Back to the checklist. We've done the step. Let's check it off. Next, we're going to be creating the dashboard structure. So we'll start with a blank sheet. And what I do with all of my templates is to select the entire sheet, change the font to the one I want to use, applies to everything at once. I'm going to change this to middle and change the justification to center. And then let's go back to the example so we can take note of the columns and the rows we need. So this goes all the way from A to J and then from 1 through 20. So we're going to recreate it exactly how it is here. So A to J, and we'll delete everything from K all the way down. And I do this with all of my templates just to make it clutter free. And it's easier for me to work with a smaller canvas. If I need to add more later, that's not a problem. And next I'm going to select this column. And the last one, I'm going to resize it to 30 and then select all of the rows, right click, resize them to 30 as well. And then I'm going to create the dashboard. So the dashboard is going to be right here. So for right now, we'll just put some outlines where things are going to go. I'll change the color to this color here, the dark gray, maintain the style. Next, we're going to create the sections right here. There's four squares underneath the dashboard panel. So we'll go here. They go from 6 to 16. So we'll put a border around that. Here's where the header is going to be. So I'll put another border there. Then I'm going to copy this, use the paint button and just paste it three more times. This last one, the title area is merged, so I'm just going to merge it here and select the entire thing and add the border, the outer border. Next, I'm going to make these columns smaller and these ones bigger. So start with the smaller one. Select every other column from C to G, right click. We're going to make it 30 and we're going to make this bigger. So B, D, F, H and I, right click, and we're going to make this 400. And I'm going to resize this rows. Instead of 30, I'm going to change it to 40. And then let's readjust these columns to 40 as well. And the reason why I'm trying to make sure that I'm using the same size for the rows and the columns is, number one, it makes it look more even. And the other thing, I want to make sure this looks like squares in the section where we have the employee's image showing up. All right, so next we're going to create the bottom two graphs. We need an area for the title and then an area for the graph. Going back here, we leave one space blank. This is going to be the header. So put a border around it. And then this is going to be the place for the graph. So select that row, right click, resize it 400. And then we can add our external border, merge this cell together, select the entire space, paint format, and place it right here. So we have these two areas for the graphs. So here's what we have so far. I'm just going to make it a little bit smaller. I think we need to fix these two columns. So right now they are at 400. So we need them to be two. Select the last two columns, resize, change that to 200. And then we can then merge the cell across and going to remove the borders and then add the borders back here. Perfect. So now these two are about the same size. I'm going to turn off the grid so we can see exactly what we're working with. All right. So here's what it looks like. like so far. You can start to add colors at this point in time if you want. To add colors, I like to use this custom color template. If I use a color from this palette everywhere in this template and I change my mind, so let's say instead of this green, I want a different color, all I need to do is change it here and it changes it for the entire template. That's the reason why I encourage you to use this. It's also very helpful if you're selling Google Sheets templates and you want to sell different versions of the template. You can create one version, then make a copy, change the colors here, and now you have another version automatically. I usually use any of the colors here that I like, and then I go to customize and change things around if I don't like some of the colors that has been pre-selected. Okay, let's go with this one and click done. And now I'm going to add some colors. I'll add this to the background. Next, I'm going to add internal rows to this last table. Select the entire internal space, go to borders. I'm going to change it to this lighter color and change the style to this one right here and select horizontal borders. And now I have these borders here. If you want it to look like this, where it alternates the colors on each row, go ahead and select it one more time, alternating colors. And we're just going to check this one off that says header and done. And here is what it's looking so far. Let's go back to our checklist. Okay, so we have completed the structure. We can cross that off. Next, we're going to add our formulas and graphs. Back to the example, we need to add some formulas and we need to add these graphs. So we have two pie charts and two bar charts to add. So we'll start with this first area here. Just to save time, I'm going to copy the headers and paste them in the template. Right click, paste special values only, and then merge these two columns so it looks like the rest of them. Here is where we're going to enter the formula. Before we do that, we're going to merge these cells. Okay, so we have these four spots. And next, we're going to count the number of active employees. And we're getting the information from the database. So we need to know how many employees are active. And if we go to our database, we have a column for employee status. So what we're trying to do is get this information to be displayed right here. So going back to the example, I'll make this bigger so you can see the formula, but I will put the formula on the screen so you can pause the video and copy it. Here's the formula. We're going to count the employee database. So if you are using this formula, make sure that you name your sheet or your tab with the exact same name. And then later on, you can change it to whatever you want and the formula would adapt accordingly. If you don't want to do that, just type in your sheet name here if you're not using the name employee database. All right, so here's the formula. It's referencing this data and it's referencing column N6, and so the entire column N starting from row 6, because that's where we have the employment status and we're trying to capture all the employees with an active status. So going back here, double click one more time. In this column, we want the active employees when there is an employee name in column B. Copy that formula and we're going to paste it right here. Select the entire space. I'm going to change it to 24, make it bold. Let's say you wanted to display inactive. You would just change the name here from active to inactive. So if I type inactive, enter, I have one employee. If I go back to the database, you can see that all of these is active except for one inactive. Let's do two more. So now we have three. So if we go back to the dashboard, we can see that the formula works the way it's supposed to. The next three formulas are based on the employment type: full-time, part-time, and contract. We also have temporary, but I only put three of the options in the dashboard. You could do whatever combination you want. You can even skip the active employees and use the entire panel up here for the employee status. So you can do full-time, part-time, temporary, and contract. All you need to do is to adapt the formula to display what you want. If we double click, you can see it's the same count if formula. This time it's referencing column M, which has the employment type, and we have full-time here. So it's counting the full-time employees and it's making sure that it's only counting it when there's an employee name in column B. If we double click on the part-time formula, it's the same thing, but instead of full-time, we have part-time. And then the last one, we have contract. All right, so I'm gonna copy the formula so you can pause the video and copy it. And back here, paste it here, full-time employees, paste it here as well, and change this to part-time. Make sure you're using the exact spelling. And the last one, change this from full-time to contract. Perfect. So now we can double check to make sure things work. I'm going to change this full-time to contract and let's do another one. So we have three contracts. Back to our dashboard, it shows up here as three. Okay, so this part is done. Remember, you can change this to fit your specific needs. Change the header to what you want displayed and then adjust the formula based on what you have in your database. Just remember that if you're going to be typing in text, it has to match the text that you have entered into the database. Let's switch over to the example. All right, so we're going to work on these two next, and then we'll come back and do all the graphs together. Here we have a dropdown, and here we have some formulas that are also pulling in information from the dashboard. Let's do the dropdown first. Click on this cell right here, go to insert to dropdown, and change it from dropdown to dropdown from range. Click on that, click on this select data range icon, and then go to your database. And what we need here is the name of employees. So I'm going to select just a few cells, go here and remove the row number. And that would automatically select the entire table all the way down to 1,000. Click OK. And then click on Advanced Options. What I want to do is change it to plain text. You could also use arrow, which is what I have used in the example. I'll change it to plain text so you can also see what that looks like. Click on that. Click Done. Let's go back here. And now it looks like nothing, but if you double click, now you can select an employee name. Okay. And here's what it looks like with the arrow. The arrow is nice because it tells you specifically that there is something to select. So it's really up to you what you want to use. Now merge this cell because we want to make sure that when this name is selected, the employee image shows up here. So I'm going to select this, go to merge. Next, you're going to have to decide what you want displayed in these cells. So here would be the name of the data, and here would be the data that needs to be displayed. So let's go back to the example. All of these come from these headers right here. So maybe here you might want to display their employment title or their department. In this example, I display their employment status, but you can use it for whatever you want. So the first thing we're going to do is add the titles and then add the formulas. For the titles, you can just type in the titles that you want based on the titles here, or you can reference that. And the reason why I like the reference option is that if you change it here, it changes in the dashboard as well. So here we have position slash title. If I go back to the dashboard, we have position slash title. If I only want it to say position and I change it to position here, let's go back to the dashboard. Now we only have position here. So this saves you the time of typing it twice. That way it's consistent. So let's go over to our template and add here. I'm gonna hit equals. Go over to your database and decide on what you want to display first. So let's say I want to keep it somewhat the same. So I will select position and then department. Next thing we're going to do is create the formulas that would pull in the position for the employee name selected here. Back to our dashboard. In this first cell, it is displaying the employee status. So if we double click, you can see that it is filtering the column with the employee status, which is column N. And it's also matching the employee name to the name selected here. So that's all this filter formula is doing. I'm going to copy it and go back to our dashboard. I'm going to paste it here. All right. And then we have active. So if we change to another employee, you can see that it says inactive. We're using the exact same formula for the rest of them. So we're going to put the image here. The image is in column C. So all we need to do is use the exact same formula, paste it here. So anywhere we have N, we're going to change it to C because C is where we have our employee image. Click enter and the image shows up here. We're going to repeat this step for all of the entries here. If I click on position, you can see it's in column H. All I have to do is paste that formula. Okay. Now it's going to say inactive because I haven't changed the location of the cell. Change it from N to H. And now it shows up as her position. Next, gender, paste that formula, change it from N to F. All right, so I've added all the formulas and this is blank because this employee is inactive. So I'm going to change it to a different employee that has a status of active. And here we can see the anniversary date and the years of service. If I move on from this area, I want to add some conditional format. So I want this and this to be green when the employee is active and a different color if they're inactive or terminated. To do this, we're going to select these two cells individually. Use command on your keyboard to select both of them. Go to color, select conditional formatting from here. And what we're going to do next is to select custom formula. And you're going to type equals this cell, H6, okay, equals, we're going to type active, okay, and then change the color to what we want. So let's say we want to use this lighter green color. So you can see that it changes here, but it doesn't change here. So before the letter H, add a dollar sign. So when you add the dollar sign, now it's going to apply the conditional formatting to both. And I'm going to change the text to a dark color so it contrasts well with this green. Now to do the next one, which is terminated, don't click done. Just click on add another rule. It's going to save this one and create a copy of the same setting so we can apply a different conditional formatting to it. So click on add another rule. And we're going to change this from active to terminated. Okay. And we're going to change the color from this green to this red color. And instead of clicking done, do one more and change this to inactive and change it to a different color. Let's use blue and click done. Okay, so now we have the three conditional formulas here. Let's check out another employee. Let's click on that and you can see that it turns blue when it's inactive. And let's terminate this employee. So change to terminated. And that is Alexander King. Go back here, change it to Alexander and it shows up like this. Okay, so everything works the way it's supposed to be working. Back to our checklist, cross this off. Now we're going to add our graphs and charts. We're going to work on these two graphs first. I'll copy the header titles just to save time So I'll paste them here as values only. And I'm going to do this as well. Department distribution and position distribution. So I'll copy these two as well and paste them here. Values only. Click on this insert chart icon and it's pre-selecting some data here. So I'm going to delete this. We're going to go to where our data is. We want a graph that represents the gender. So I'm going to go ahead and select this column. Remove the row number and it will automatically apply it to the entire column. Click on OK. So you see this button that says aggregate. We want to click on that. And then once we do that, you can see it shows up male versus female. I want this to be represented in a pie chart. And here's what it looks like. And you can just move it to where you want it to be and resize. Double click to open up the settings again. I'm going to remove the background and the border and change the legend to left. And that way fits right into the space that I have already created for it. And you can see male versus female. Let's go back to our database. Let's add other. So let's add three versions for other. Back to the dashboard, you can see that it is working how we expect it to work. Next, we'll do the same thing. Click on insert charts, click on data range, go to our database. We want to add employment status. So select some of the column, go into that space and remove the number of the row. So it selects the entire column and click OK. We're going to do the same thing, aggregate. And it automatically selects this chart, which is fine. You can use this if you want. To keep it consistent with the example, I will change it to a pie chart as well and do the exact same thing I did before. Change the background, change the legend to left. And then I'm going to just resize it into this space. Next, we're going to create our department distribution. Click on insert chart, data range, go to our database, column I, select that, remove the row number, click OK. And the same thing, we want to aggregate and then make a few changes, remove the background and the border and just resizing it for it to fit right here. The last one is position distribution. The exact same steps, insert charts, data range, and now we need data from H. Remove the row number, click OK, aggregate, readjust it. So if we look at my example, you can see I have different colors for department distribution and different colors for position. I also have numbers here. So let's do that next. Go back here and double click in this graph, go to series and go to data labels. Click on that. Once you do that, you see the numbers appear in each bar. Now I'm going to position it to center. Okay, so it shows up right here in the middle. Next thing I'm going to do is select the bar. Starting with the first one, this formatting option opens up. I'm going to change it to this color. Okay, click on the second one. And then you can do the same if you want for the different positions. So you can double click and just apply the colors you want to apply. So we're back to our checklist and we have done this step, which is essentially the last step for the tutorial. I'm going to show you a copy of a similar template that I have for sale. If you want a more comprehensive template that has more features, I'll leave a link in the description box. And for the Patreon, this template we have just created, you will get a free copy of it. So if you don't want to worry about the structure or the formulas or anything like that, and you want to save time, go over to my Patreon. I will leave a link in the description box. You can go ahead and support me in that way. Thank you so much for my current Patreon members. Not only will you get access to this template that we created, you'll have access to all of the templates that I have created a tutorial for on my YouTube channel. All right, here is the demo copy of the template that I have for sale. It is an employee directory template. However, it can be customized to be used for a different purpose. So we do have a dashboard here. Here is a directory. In addition to that, I have created several different tabs that will display your employee directory. We have a general directory that you can filter by department, a new hire directory, an anniversary directory, and then a custom directory. That way you can pull up your employee information in different ways. So if you want to display the birthdays that are coming up for the month, you can select the month and the employees with the birthdays in that month would show up and you can print it out and distribute it for your employees. This template is available in my digital template shop. I will leave links, like I said before, so you can go ahead and check it out. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions, don't forget to leave them in the comment section below. Subscribe if you haven't done so already. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you in the next one.